Hey guys, LoadedBadge28 here, and I'm going to be playing some automation. Now, it's gonna be kind of a long video, but we will see how it goes. The car you see on the thing is one of the cars I've made in my past. And I will come back to the video when it is time. Alright, we are back. I don't know if you can hear it or not, but we will see how it goes. Let's go to the car. Let's go to the engine designer. Let's design a new engine. Design a 60-degree V8 with an aluminum head. The overhead cams. We'll do, I think it's 3.92. Something like that. A 5.2 liter V8. We're gonna do cast iron and everything. Keep the compression in. Do 10 to 1 compression. Keep the profile where it's at. Not gonna do that. We're gonna do 2.0 EFI per cylinder. Standard. With premium fuel. And a 14.7. Dual exhaust with bypass valves. Two-way, reverse, and reverse. So we're making about 287 horsepower with this particular motor. Let's see if we can hear what it sounds like. RPMs out of it. And we will put that same engine inside a car. Let's put that V8 into a sports car body. What kind of sports car we can get to put it in this thing here. Thank you. let's find a good color for this car. I'm thinking somewhere along the lines like dark mahogany red, like this. There we are. Need to get a certain set of headlights for it. Start putting these on it. Do this one here. And conveniently enough, those fit perfectly in their hole. And we will do the same with the rear end. We're gonna put these ones in the rear end. Right here. You wanna increase the size of them a little bit. And widen them just a little bit. For indicators, I'll just put a simple little square indicator on the side of the car. Crap, let's get that one off there. Something like this might do better. There we go. I'm gonna put a vent on the side of the car. Something like this will do. Scoop, but I do want to put a sunroof on this car. This needs to be widened and made a little bit bigger. There we go. Let me know if you guys like these videos. It has been a long time since I've done something like this, so go 7-speed automatic with a top speed of like 185. Automatic lockers for differentials and then chunky off-road tires. Let's look at the offset, see if I need to offset the tires a little bit. There we go. In a car like this, you want vented disc on the front and vented disc on the back. Off-road skid tray. This is a luxury 2012 model year car with electric power steering. Just do hydro pneumatic off-road setup. And then we have a little bit of stuff we need to change here. We're not looking to make it entirely comfortable because it is an off-road style vehicle, but we do want it to be a little bit more comfortable than it is. Sorry if my audio cut out. My headset's still kind of wore out. Cool. I could have put nicer rims on it, but I wanted to get it out and built. It's alright, let's put this let's build a turbo version of the same V8. Compression down. Back to this one and edit real quick. So I forgot to put exhaust, I forgot to put mufflers and door handles and stuff on it. Let's put like one of these little shark fins on the back of it. Export it and then we'll continue our way. Design one more car, and then we are going to call it on this video. turned off and I have to test the style door handles. Yep. it's a funny looking car, but I think it'll do pretty good once we test it. Okay, so this game has been, this car has been exported to BeamNG Drive, and we will test it out in the next video. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and if you did, hit that like button and let me know. Otherwise, I'll see y'all later. Bye.